Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Israel. Topping our news, the U.S. has indicted 11 suspected pirates accused of attacking our Navy ships off the coast of Africa. The suspects will stand trial in Norfolk, Virginia, because the American nation of Kenya began refusing to take piracy suspects earlier this month. In addition to the piracy count, the charges include attacks to plunder a Navy vessel, assault with a dangerous weapon, and the use of firearms during a crime of violence.
For more now, we turn to Regent University Law Professor David Valoney to give us more information and insight into this story. Thank you so much for being here.
It's good to be here.
Well, first of all, the Kenyans say the trials of these alleged pirates were straining on its courts. How so?
Well, I think, first of all, it's just good that the Kenyans are involved at all. It wasn't until about 2008 that they worked out jurisdictional issues, and we've kind of been able to put modern justice, against pirates. But there's just been an increased effort through task forces to bring in more pirates to try to deter this type of activity off the coast of Africa. And I think that the resources that the Kenyans have, it's expensive to try cases. It's expensive in terms of evidence gathering and being able to put these cases together. And I think the Kenyans just decided that they couldn't handle the load.
Mm-hmm. State Department spokesman P.J. Crowley said, and I'm quoting here, "This is where all countries have to step up and just as we are doing, take responsibility for pirates who have attacked their ships and prosecute them to the fullest extent of the law." Your thoughts on that?
I actually agree with the State Department spokesman on that. I think that there is no international criminal court to handle specifically pirates. There's no that have jurisdiction over pirates. Mm-hmm. And if each nation who's got the greatest stake in deterring pirates from attacking their vessels steps up and prosecutes these individuals, then I think we will be able to effectively thwart continuing efforts. So certainly there's military responses and other responses, but each nation needs to take it responsibility for themselves to protect its own vessels.
Real quickly, what can we expect in terms of an outcome for these trials, you're thinking?
First of all, piracy carries with it a life sentence, and I think that these folks may, in fact, our federal prosecutors will be able to do a good job as long as the evidence is gathered, and there's really no impediments under international law. There's plenty of precedent going back to the days of Blackbeard and Captain Kidd. And so I think we'll be able to see justice exacted against these individuals.
All right. Thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate your time.
Thank you for inviting me.
In other news, President Obama's health care law will drive up the nation's health care costs instead of bringing them down. That's the verdict from government economic forecasters at the Department of Health and Human Services. The experts do say the new law will meet the president's goal of getting coverage for 34 million Americans, but they say the law's Medicare cuts may be unrealistic and could make it harder for seniors to get care, while driving up about 15% of hospitals in the red.
The Obama administration will defend the National Day of Prayer in court. The Justice Department is appealing a Wisconsin judge's ruling, which said the annual event is unconstitutional because it amounts to a call for religious action. The administration says the law simply acknowledges the role of religion in the U.S. The judge did allow observances of the day to continue until appeals are exhausted. Some legal analysts believe the case could go all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court. The Army has rescinded an invitation to Evangelist Franklin Graham to speak at the Pentagon on the National Day of Prayer. An Army spokesperson cited Graham's critical comments of Islam for that decision. Graham has called Islam a, quote, evil and wicked religion and criticized its treatment of women. He says he wants Muslims to know Jesus Christ died for their sins. The Army says those kinds of remarks are inappropriate in today's all-inclusive Army. Congressman Randy Forbes of Virginia says it's a sign of political correctness taking over.
We're getting to the part in the country where what I want to do is try to exclude everybody from speaking if I disagree with what they're going to say or if I'm offended by what they're going to say. I can assure you of this. If we're going to apply that rule, we're going to have a lot of people who are not allowed to speak on the floor of the House of Representatives because I'm offended by what they say.
Graham says he regrets the Army's decision, but he will continue to pray for the troops.
Well, Senator Jim DeMint tells CBN News that the Tea Party movement is a spiritual revival waiting to happen. He tells our David Brody that as people turn away from a dependency on government, they will, in effect, turn back to God.
I really think a lot of the motivation behind these Tea Party crowds is a spiritual component. I think it's very akin to the Great Awakening before the American Revolution. I think as this thing continues to roll, you're going to see a parallel spiritual revival that goes along with it.
Senator DeMint will be David's featured newsmaker of the week on his internet show. It's called The Brody File, and you can watch it by going to cbnnews.com.
Thousands of planes are back in the skies a week after a volcano shut down dozens of European airports. British Christians came forward to help passengers who were stranded, and many believe this was a special time for their nation. The volcano shut down British airspace for 6 days, and the immense backlog of flights means it will be quite some time before all the stranded travelers finally make it home. In the heat of the crisis, Manchester Airport chaplain Kevin Ball stepped in to serve.
When it was closed and we've still got passengers here, we were very conscious in making sure that they were okay, both physically, mentally, and spiritually.
With thousands of passengers stranded at the height of the stop down, Ball says local churches also came to their aid.
We're very fortunate in so much that members of the public and local from local churches came and offered accommodation to people who were stranded.
Meantime, Christians in the UK believe there are spiritual implications to the crisis. Christian business leaders gathered in Northwest England this week for a special evening of prayer for the country. They say God is using this time to shake the nation.
I thought it was an excellent focus for people in the fact that the whole of the airlines were grounded for 6 days, giving people chance to sit back and listen and think about the awesomeness of God.
Just to let people know that the forces of nature are indeed awesome, and that the best plans or best laid plans of men may not always come to fruition.
Our world is changing around us. The certainties we've taken for granted have suddenly turned out not to be certainties at all. There's 150,000 people out there trying to get home. Their certainties have certainly crumbled.
The airways were shut down by the power of God, or the forces of nature, and the symbol in the middle of it was ash. It's a clear call to repentance.
The NFL held its annual draft last night, and no surprise who went number one.
With the first pick in the 2010 NFL Draft, the St. Louis Rams select Sam Bradford, quarterback, Oklahoma.
But Sam has his work cut out for him. The Rams won just one game last year and six games over the last 3 years. Recently, CBN's Sean Brown sat down with Bradford and asked him how he handles challenges.
Since the game's inception, hundreds of thousands of young men have played collegiate football, but only 74 hold the distinction of winning the Heisman Trophy. In 2008, Sam Bradford joined Tim Tebow as the youngest ever to be inducted into this exclusive group of gridiron stars. And now, as a top NFL draftee, he's relying on his faith to help him keep his priorities in order.
I do realize that God has given me so many blessings in my life. You know, I am living through Him, and that I have a responsibility, you know, to set an example for younger kids, to show them that, you know, you can't do things on your own. You know, God will help you, He will guide you, and it's a great thing to have Him in your life.
Sam realizes he'll face enormous pressure in the NFL.
That could be a humbling experience, knowing that the weight of the team is on your shoulders.
Yeah.
How do you deal with that?
I think God, you know, when you spend time with Him, you know, and the more you read, the more He shows you by example, you know, what it is to be a leader.
One of those examples came the night before his first game as a starter, when he read the story of David and Goliath.
Obviously, I was really nervous, and, you know, I was looking to the Lord for strength, and it's just something that He pointed me towards. But, you know, the thing that I just love about that story is, you know, David went out there, and not only, you know, he didn't go out there as David, he went out there, you know, David with God and through God. And, you know, I really felt confident when I took the field, knowing, you know, that He was right there behind me. And it's something that, you know, just kind of happened to come in tradition, and something I do before every game now.
As Sam heads to the NFL, he understands that many will say that the ultimate goal to strive for is a Super Bowl championship. But for him, he's striving for much more.
I really don't see a reason why you wouldn't want to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. I mean, you know, not only was He the greatest human being ever to walk the earth, But, I mean, he's everything that I want to strive for. He's everything that anyone should want to strive for.
Operation Blessing is still helping Haitians recover from January's devastating earthquake. OB is teaming up with Lifesaver Relief to provide portable water filtration systems known as jerry cans. Team members are distributing the jerry cans and bottles to villagers, relief camps, and orphanages. See, OB is focusing on mothers of nursing infants and young children since they're most vulnerable to sickness. For the past 2 years, OB International has used the Lifesaver technology with 100% success.
Comedy Central has pulled a clip from the cartoon South Park after threats from radical Muslims. A group called Revolution Muslim is outraged over a recent episode of the often vulgar and controversial show. It mocked the Prophet Muhammad, along with Jesus Christ and other religious figures. The Muslim group posed a statement on its website saying the cartoon's two creators could be killed because depictions of Muhammad are not allowed in Islam. The group even published the producer's work address on its website.
Coming up, the amazing new documentary called Oceans is now playing in theaters. We'll check in with our movie critic to find out if it's family friendly.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection. You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith.
Amazing love,
get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99. Here I am to worship. Here I am.
But wait. Order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just
$9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Several new movies hit the big screen this week, but are they family-friendly? I spoke with Bob Waliszewski with Focus on the Family's Plugged-In Department to find out just a bit earlier. Bob, let's talk about some of the new movies coming out this week. First, I wanted to ask your opinion of the new documentary or doc-drama documentary called Oceans. It's supposed to have some beautiful underwater imagery. What are your thoughts on that one?
Well, it came out on Thursday, and this is Disney's follow-up to last year's movie that came out on Earth Day called Earth. But this time we're going underneath the oceans to see animals we've seen before on TV or maybe seen along the ocean, whales and sharks and sea turtles and a whole lot of creatures that we've never laid eyes on. This movie, this documentary, never mentions God, but there is no way you can come away from this movie without thinking, wow, we have a wonderful designer and creator. Now, I do need to sound just a couple of little warnings. Not enough warnings that I would say to steer clear of, but unlike the Earth, this one has a little bit of evolutionary messaging throughout the script, the billions of years and coming from the sea. And one other word of warning, animals, cute little animals, get eat other cute little animals. Mm-hmm. So especially among the youngsters, you might hear an occasional yelp or two. I know even myself, when I was watching these sea turtles, little sea turtles going to the ocean and the birds picking them off, I was kind of like, oh no, come on, sea turtles. So anyways, messages to talk through before you go and after you go. But I think it's very family friendly, and I recommend Oceans.
Good. Good. Some good precautionary advice there. Also wanted to ask you about the new romantic comedy coming out, The Backup Plan, starring Jennifer Lopez. What can you tell us about that one?
Boy, Jennifer Lopez, this film was a disappointment. In a nutshell, she gets pregnant in her doctor's office because she's not found a guy in her life and she's tired of waiting. And of course, as soon as she goes through this procedure with her doctor, she finds Mr. Right, or at least she believes he's Mr. Right. Only he has to deal with the fact that now she's pregnant. And we find out later, not just with a single baby, but with twins. Sadly, even though this film is a PG-13, supposedly okay for your 13-year-old on up, it is just loaded with hormonally charged dialogue from start to finish. Now, if I had to say something nice about the film, and this is something positive, not a recommendation, it's the fact that nowhere does Jennifer Lopez's character ever consider abortion. And so, I mean, that was good. But outside of that, the rest of the film, for me, was a big loser.
She's still struggling to make a comeback. Looking ahead, what about some of the new things coming out this summer? What are you looking forward to?
You know, Toy Story 3 is coming out, and I just have to think that it's going to be really, really good. Walden Media has a new film coming out this summer, Ramona and Beezus, based on the popular book series. I'm actually optimistic about a film called The Last Airbender. Of course, I haven't seen it. I'm not recommending it, but we'll see. And, of course, the big films, Iron Man 2 will be extremely big, and Robin Hood coming out on May 14th with Russell Crowe, stands to do very well at the box office. Will it be family friendly? Well, stay tuned to this feature, because as soon as we take a look, we'll be letting you know.
All right. Thanks a lot. We'll be getting a break this summer, that is for sure. Bob Olszewski, thank you so much again.
You bet. Thank you.
Up next, reaching out to single moms, how one group is trying to help them survive and thrive.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase, and the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
In health news, eating too much of certain carbohydrates may increase the risk of heart disease in women. A new study found heart disease was more prevalent among women than men who eat carbs with a high glycemic index. That includes foods like white bread, pizza, rice, and sugar-laden foods. High glycemic carbs can increase blood glucose levels, triglycerides, and cholesterol.
Well, one quarter of American children live with a single parent, and most of those parents are single moms. Many of those moms need job skills and support, and recently one organization was invited to Capitol Hill to help them. Jennifer Wishon explains.
They all have different stories and circumstances. Some are divorced, some got pregnant out of wedlock, others lost their husbands at war. But no matter how they became single moms, they all face the same struggles. Oklahoma Congresswoman Mary Fallon knows about them personally. She raised her children on her own for years, all while pursuing a fast-paced career in politics as her state's first female lieutenant governor and as a member of the House of Representatives.
My mother used to always tell me, you're not the first woman that's ever had this happen to you, so get up, get going. You know, we don't have to go under the mountain, we can go over the mountain. We don't have to have a pity party, you know, we can rise above all that.
Helping women rise above it and stopping what she calls the generational curse that's passed down from grandmother to mother to grandchild is something Fallon is passionate about.
And I really think one of the ways that we can better our states is by empowering our citizens and letting them know that they're not alone and helping them find a better path to life.
She recently invited Arise Ministries to Capitol Hill. The Oklahoma-based ministry has been helping single moms thrive for 6 years and is on a mission to expand nationwide.
I believe that we as citizens, especially Christians in the church, it's our responsibility to reach out to these modern-day orphans and widows.
The ministry was born in Pam Cannelly's heart. She was a single mom, too. The ministry is based on Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. There is no better example of its outreach than a two-day event held each year. 2 days that often change the lives of single moms forever.
It's amazing. You know, one single mom one time said, you know what, all year long, you know, I give and give and give to my children, but survive and thrive is my Christmas.
While the kids play in childcare, moms are given the royal treatment and taught life skills like overcoming anger and bitterness, dealing with their children's dad, handling teenagers, time management, and even taking care of things like a broken toilet.
When that happens, it doesn't seal off the bottom of that tank.
Arise has already been welcomed into 5 states. On Capitol Hill, Cannelly and Executive Director Shelley Pulliam urged lawmakers to help them grow even more. Unlike most people here, they're not looking for money, just contacts.
It is the belief of the ministry that the plight of single moms affects everyone. If you aren't one, chances are you know one, because about a quarter of children in the U.S. now live with a single mom. These are women struggling to be everything to their children, who are America's future leaders.
It's a struggle on many levels. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, less than half of single moms awarded child support actually receive the full amount. And that's just the beginning. Fatherless homes account for high numbers of children with behavior problems, high school dropouts, young people in prison, and youth suicides. As a teacher working in both affluent and poor schools, Shelley Pulliam says she's seen the effect on children firsthand.
I've seen the kids be affected through taking on those burdens that their mom is feeling. I've seen a decline in their grades. I've seen anger and unforgiveness. I've seen tears.
That's why Moms Say the Survive and Thrive conference makes such a difference.
I feel strong again. You know, when I came here, I was broken, and I got a lot to fix still, but I feel able to go on.
Some even go home with Jesus in their hearts.
We can do anything we want to do. Our life circumstances don't have to hold us back.
Congresswoman Mary Fallon is proof. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Wow.
I'm the child of a single parent. You're also a single parent yourself.
Single parent.
How difficult.
And let me tell you, it is the hardest job I've ever had to do. And that's why the church really needs to step up and do more. Some mm-hmm. churches are really good at it, but there are a lot that are lacking. And mm-hmm. single women need, single parents, single mothers particularly, need a lot of support mm-hmm. financially, emotionally.
Yeah.
Just support, period.
Indeed. And sometimes it's just little things.
Yeah.
Little things.
Help with the car.
Yeah.
Groceries in the house.
You got it.
Yeah.
Coming up, how one child is crediting SpongeBob SquarePants with helping her save her friend's life.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new, or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With a step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
And finally this afternoon, a 12-year-old girl says the show SpongeBob SquarePants helped her to save her friend's life.
Miriam Starobin and Allison Golden were in music class this week when Allison began choking on gum. Miriam says she immediately remembered a SpongeBob episode where he does the Heimlich maneuver.
And Miriam, she goes, Allie, are you choking? And I go...
Miriam's Heimlich maneuver did the trick. The gum flew out and Allison caught her breath. Oh, and by the way, no gum, candy, food, or drinks are allowed in that class. So after this happened, the girl's music teacher said that SpongeBob can apparently save anyone's life.
Go SpongeBob.
Lived in something under a sea.
I love it. He's a hero. Well, that's all for this edition of CBN News Midday. You can find information on all the stories you've seen right here at CBNNews.com.
You can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. Hope you join us again right here next time. Have a wonderful weekend.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance
in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.
I had this great idea, but I felt like I was the only one who could see its potential. I imagined not just what I could do, but what I could be in business. That's why I went to Regent for my college degree. They brought out God's best in me, so I could bring my best to the world.
At Regent, you can study online or on campus. For more information, visit regentundergrad.com or call 1-800-210-0060.
When you choose Regent, you're choosing to change your life.